Good to go.
Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the culminating concert, final concert of the WAISAL Band Festival, the second WAISAL Band Festival that we've had in the history of WAISAL. So welcome, everyone. This afternoon. It's going to be a wonderful afternoon of music. United States. You've been working really hard and really intensively for the past 4 days to put this concert on for you. We've got schools coming in from Lincoln Community School in Accra, Ghana. We've got the American International School of Lagos with us. We've got the International School of Dakar with us. We've also got the International Community School of Abidjan with us, making up this concert this afternoon. It's been a really special 3 days of the students who've been working, collaborating together, sharing their musical expertise, sharing their musical experience with each other, and coming together and really pulling it all together in this final concert this afternoon. And a big thing about WAISAL, especially the band, is bringing all this music together. But another really important piece of this is bringing friendships together. There's the connections and the reconnections that we've made over the past 3 days that are absolutely fantastic. And of course, that's going to go on in the future. As many of these students will be going on to other WAISAL events coming up this year, but also WAISAL events next year as we travel to other schools and those connections will be repeated there, which is a really important part of this whole process. I'd like to now introduce to you Dr. Jim Smart from the University of Montana, and he's been working with students over the past 3 days, bringing them all together, working with the band directors, bringing them all together so that they can bring this concert to you. He's been sharing his expertise and his experiences, which are vast and many. I won't go into it today because we'll be going on forever. But Dr. Jim Smart, welcome you to the stage to lead us this afternoon.
Activate all the emotions that we do when we are just in normal conversation and treating others. has presented to Canada, Kim Ishimura. I graduated from the University of Toronto in composition not long ago. And she was driving in the western part of the country, the University of Columbia, heading west as the setting sun was happening over the mountains in western BC. And she had this tremendous urge to try to keep up with the sun, and hopefully if she drove fast enough, that the sun would never set. So there's this feeling of perpetual motion in this piece that's called Chasing Sunlight.
Write a Nigerian piece for this man. So this is Nigerian wedding.
talk to people, like many will recognize a lot of the themes. And then also one aspect of the music, it's party music. So on their occasional times where the composer writes in multiple keys, he calls it pandiatonicism. So you're going to hear what sounds like people playing in multiple keys, but there's always a real heavy groove for this sort of music. Because their fearless leader went to get the screwdriver.
We're gonna do the buckets.
Slight change of pecking lines. The next piece we're gonna play, because a lot of percussionists came this year, and music just doesn't have enough parts for it, so we put together a percussion ensemble piece. But before we play this piece, I wanted to take a second to thank the four schools and their AEDs and their teachers and chaperones that came. That is your guest, AISA, Mr. New. So Okay, we are ready. This piece is called Funky Buckets.
Before we play our last and most difficult piece, I want to give my thanks to these wonderful students that have had a great time getting to know over the last 2 days. But to Mr. Panton and the rest of the band that are here, all of you, I have a lot of time to hang out in the evenings and talk shop and just get to know each other and create relationships that are going to be long-lasting. I've been so amazingly impressed with the sincerity and the support of the administration and the fellow teachers at this school at AISA for this event, and I hope that this and next year transmits and keeps this strong tradition going when this is going to be posted in another school next year. Thank you so much for all those people. If you know anything about the Irish, there's colorful poetry. There's a lot of humor in the culture. And these are three Irish street ballads, two of them being quite humorous and one being quite tragic. And before each movement, and then at the very end of the song, after we perform, the soloists brought the piece are going to stand up. And then I'll have the entire band stand up. The first one is called A Long Fred Legend. It tells the tale of a captain who forgot to teach his crew how to stop a boat. Oh, tis the bold major today of all relate, who possessed a fine house in a charming estate. Who, when possible, always his pleasure would take from morning till night in a boat on his lake. So it was steam launch he bought from a neighboring pier, and he learned how to starboard to stoker his steer. But the part of the craft he awaited to learn, how to ease her and stop her and back her astern. Well, one lovely spring morn, from their moorings they cast, the furnace alight and the steam full blast. As the cruise through the lake, oh, what a pleasure was theirs. What congratulation, what swagger, what airs. Evening's come, said the major. Let's home for the night. I'll pick up the morning and make her all right. The morning, I'll stew my stoker your wages to earn just easier and stop her back her astern. Do what? Asked the stoker. Why stop her, of course. It's easier stopping a runaway horse. Just try it yourself to feel officer swore. That was no use. They were nearly on shore. He swore himself like a boatman and crew. He cursed the funnel, the boiler, and his crew. But in vain he was forced from his mooring to turn, shouting, ease her and stop her and back her astern. It was clear that on shore that night they would not dine. So they drank the brandy and the whiskey and the wine. They finished the stew and demolished the cake as they steamed full steam all night around the lake. Weeks passed, and with terror and famine oppressed, one by one that ill-fated crew sank to rest. And grim death seized the major before he could learn how to ease her and stop her and back her astern.
Thank you.
Young Long and Long. Come, all you young gallants that follow the gun, beware of the little shooting at the setting sun. For it's little you know what happened of late to young Molly, whose beauty was great. It happened one evening in a shower of hail. This maid in a bower herself did conceal. Her love being shooting took her for a fawn. He leveled his gun and he shot Molly on. And when he came to her and found it was she, his limbs they grew feeble and his eyes could not see. His heart was broken with sorrow and grief, and with eyes up to heaven and implored for relief. He ran to his uncle with the gun in his hand, saying, "Uncle, dear uncle, I'm not able to stand. I shot my own true love, alas, and undone, while she was in the shade of the setting of the sun. I rubbed her fair temples and found she was dead, and a fountain of tears for my dark eyes shed. And now I'll be forced by the laws of the land, for the killing of my daughter, I try to stand." Devil, he hoisted her up on his back after 7 years gone, 9 days coming back. Says he, the old man, here's your wife, safe and well. For the likes of her, we would not have been happy. Now I've been a devil most of my life, but I've never been in hell until I met your wife.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've got a fantastic afternoon of music. Again, I give you the WAISAL Band Festival. One more time, please. Wonderful. With the community school, international school in Dakar, American International School Abuja, international community school in Abidjan, and of course, international, American International School in Abuja. And all this in 3 hours. Absolutely fantastic. And finally, also, thank you, Dr. Jim. Thank you so much.